Well, I'd like to welcome you all to the first colloquium of the semester. We're getting started a little late this semester, but we have a full schedule from here on out, chock full of exciting talks. We're going to start things off this week with one of our own, Dr. Milorad Cvijetic. He is a professor in the College of Optical Sciences. He joined us in 2011. Before that, he was vice president and chief technology strategist at NEC Corporation of America. He's been working in telecommunications for 30 years, has published a large number of papers, 4 books, I think a recent book too, and 12 patents. And he's going to talk to us today about optical quantum communications and what to expect.
Okay, thanks much for your kind introduction, and thanks for coming. Hopefully this will be a good presentation, and you may find something interesting inside. So optical quantum communications, you will find some people that are very skeptical about this, and some other they are very enthusiastic, and let's see what's going on and what we can expect in the future. Since we have some number of students, I will spend some time, maybe 10 minutes or so, just to introduce some fundamentals, starting from qubits and how we manipulate with them, and then talk about key components related to communication, quantum communication, which is quantum key distribution and teleportation. And after that, really about key devices, what we need. Then what is the most important, and of course one important stuff is to increase bit rate and security of everything. And then we'll comment on some achieved results, heroic experiments, and what we can expect. And of course, there is something I did together with some people around. Okay, so let's start talking about this. What is quantum information processing? So it is some kind of combination information theory and quantum mechanics or quantum physics. So which is ideal? I mean, for people from College of Optical Sciences, you have both of flavors. And with respect to that, application is for communication and computing, the same principles. So we are talking about CC, or better to say, quantum communication and computing. Now, we are talking about qubits in classical communications and computer science. We are talking about bits. So I will talk about what is qubit. And here we are talking about quantum bits, so qubits. If we have more than two states, we are talking about qubits. Then, if we have communication, the goal is to transfer qubits from one space, one location to the other. If you are talking about computing, then we are really talking about transformation of arbitrary quantum state. So qubit is quantum state. So we are basically used to say, okay, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1. It could be either 1 or 0, so it is binary. But here we can say, okay, it could be both. It is some kind of superposition of both states, 1 or 0. So we have something that is a little bit fluid. And you know, our basic principle of quantum mechanics, we are going to talk about that later on. So talking about that, it is superposition of both state basis states. So instead of, you know, having classical 0, 1, 0, 1, we are really talking about this quantum mechanics denotation, so about ket, so ket 1, ket 0. So qubit state is superposition of these two kets. So let's say this is quantum state. We can write it like this. So this is linear superposition. And you see alpha and beta, they are probability amplitudes that it will be either 0 ket or 1 ket. And what is the worst, alpha and beta could be complex numbers. So you see how n representation, of course, we can use block sphere and then put it like this. So in such a case, we have probability coefficients given like this. So you can locate different states. For example, this qubit state is right here. So we are talking about pure qubit state, which is this one, but also there are some mixed states, and they are located inside of this block sphere. What else is important here? Since we have probabilities, of course, there is relationship. So probability of outcome 0 is like this, alpha square, and outcome of 1 is beta square, and this is relationship. Of course, this is only certainty for now. So what can be done with qubits? Let's talk about that. We can construct quantum logic gate, which is basic entity for quantum computation. So, and then what we do with this, it is a kind of unitary transformation of qubits around that block sphere. We can do measurement, and this is the key. It is not really measurement. It is having impact of quantum state. So we can measure this. So it could be 0 with this probability or 1 with this probability. However, measuring this, we are really altering values of probability. So if you measure something and the result of measurement is 0, then probability is 1, right? Immediately. So that is the point. So well-known fact from quantum mechanics. Then a lot of people basically relate quantum stuff, communication, computing with this entanglement. So the point is, we have two or more qubits joined together, coupled together, or whatever, linked together, that they can be presented with joint quantum state. So whatever happens with one half, if you have two qubits entangled, basically have reflection to the other. And of course, I will pay attention. We will talk about that later on. So presenting that, what is the state? So usually when we talk about, you know, this is a lot of stuff that deals with, you know, Einstein, Rose, Podolsky paradox and Bell state. So we are somehow supposed to switch from classical mathematics to this representation. So in this case, really, if you assume that quantum state is polarization, we can assume, for example, this state could be, or this state, something like that. So the point is, when a particular property is measured on one particle, the opposite states will be observed on other instantaneously, regardless of distance. And there is some small print, fine print. And, you know, as always, it is the most important. So let's see what it says. Yes, it could be like this and far away. So somebody says, okay, then it means that something can travel faster than speed of the light. Not so far, superluminal speed. So it is impossible to predict prior measurement. It is not possible to communicate via entangled particles. So in order to have that, recognize what happened, we really need to have classical communication channel between two particles. When we have classical communication channel, there is no speed higher than speed of the light. And finally, we have quantum teleportation. You know, it is idea that is used for quantum communications very often, but not necessarily. It is just one method that can be used. So if I have two entangled particles at first place and give one to sender, which is called Alice, and receiver is Bob. Is Bob here? Okay, so we have half of that. So then we can use that. The point is, of course, we are going to couple some third one with Alice, and after that we'll see how Bob reacts. So it will be really dealing at least with three qubits in this case, so I will explain that. Okay, so talking about quantum communication, I'm not talking about quantum computing. So quantum communication, we really have a quantum key distribution and teleportation. So what is quantum key distribution? We would like always to have the most secure transfer of information. So quantum key distribution is not really used to transfer information. It is used to deliver some key, and you know, if I have my information classical 0101, if I have some key recognized, I can apply XOR, and basically after that I have absolutely secure information if nobody can break this information, this code. So far, what's going on? This stuff depends on processing power and algorithm of supercomputers, but assumption is that always there is always somebody with very powerful computer he can break. In this case, he cannot because of quantum mechanical principles. And teleportation, basically, the same a kind of purpose like this, and also when you have computing, when you do some operation and would like instantly, it means that it opens the door to super high speed computation. Okay, so what is principle we are using? What are principles we are using? Two of them. So basically, to understand that it is not just entanglement, it is one half. The second half is prepare and measure protocols. So there is always something. I have quantum state. I need to do something, and I should apply some procedure, some protocol. So first one is prepare and measure. And this stuff is really based on Heisenberg principle. So when I have something, unknown quantum states, if there is somebody that would like to get some information, he's supposed to measure that, right? In order to get information, and there is impact on that. So it means I cannot prevent somebody coming, but I can detect. Detecting, basically, I can eliminate what happened, and what is left is absolutely secure. And the second one, state, is really based on non-cloning theorem. It is not possible to produce identical copies of unknown quantum states. That's the point. So, you know, this stuff, they are related. So when we combine, when we have entangled stuff distributed to two parties, it could be like this. You know, it could be there is the source of entangled photons, and there is A and B, and I give one to this and one to this. So it is a kind of clumsy. So probably the source could be here, local to Alice, giving one photon, and the second one is transmitted. So the same principle as used with A. And there are protocols. So talking about that, we are really talking about protocols. These guys, they established the way to practically use these quantum properties. So BB84 is really the best known protocol. This is these two guys invented that. And for this stuff, we have E91, Eckhart 91 protocol that it is used. After that, we have a number of modified protocols, so probably like 10 that can be used. So I would say one of key stuff is let's define some new protocol. And you will see later on There are some other assumptions related to, I would say, real life. So let's talk about quantum key distribution. So it is one of the stuff, and how to achieve that, how to achieve unbreakable code. What we would like ideally to have, if I have some speed, maybe 10 gigabits, I would like to have the key the same speed. Then I just apply, it is real time, but it is not possible. This is much slower. And one of the keys is really to try to increase this speed bit rate so somehow I can have more secure. Otherwise, I will be repeating this. Okay. So, in such a case, the classical system analysis with what we are going to do through is we have transmitter A and Alice, B, Bob, and there is some attempt to access information, and it is called Eve. So, you see, and that it is third party Eve can access information, but Bob and Alice will have information when and at what extent, and they can react. There is no other way. If you use protection using algorithms, you don't know if somebody already accessed that or maybe. So, as I mentioned, it will disturb quantum state, and that was the reason they can discover that Eve is there. And based on that, they take some action. So, right now, if you say, okay, it is balloony, there is, I have some diagram later on, a number of experiments with deployed systems. There are a few companies that they produce, QKD systems. I'm coming from company NEC. I was there at that time when some amazing experiments are done. And probably having that information, and I am quite convinced it is coming at what time, when it is cost efficient, and there is high interest, that is always how it works. So we can expect that. So 2006, 2007, some experiments were done, and I already prepared. It was real-time deployment. There was two locations in Tokyo suburb, but you will see some other amazing stuff like free space transmission over 150 kilometers. And, of course, there are some preconditions that should be done in this case. What is absolute secure communication? Look at this. The real secure communication is no communication at all. If I don't communicate, it is secure. But what is close to that? If I have communication using quantum state. Quantum state, we are really talking about photons. If I have quantum state, if I have a photon, I am very close to nothing. So basically, when you consider from communication theory, my signal can basically go down below noise level. So that is the key. And of course, in order to achieve that, what I need single photon sources. I need entangled photon sources. I need single photon detectors or so. If I don't have that, then some kind of emulation. I need quantum repeaters. So far, heroic experiment will talk about that. Other optical fibers, depending what kind of optical fiber, let's say 0.15 dB per kilometer was 260 kilometers. Through space, it was 150 kilometers, which is good enough to have communication with satellites. But how about longer distance? Repeaters. I need repeaters. And, of course, how to increase bit rate. That is the key, and everything to be economical, nice, smaller, and so. So before moving, one more. So I explained quantum key distribution, what is all about. Quantum teleportation. quantum information, you know, information about state of photon, quantum state, is transferred from one location to the other. So we have two locations. So again, Alice and Bob. And previously, there was a pair of entangled photons, A and B, and half of that A is delivered to Alice and B, Bob. As I mentioned, it could be here, and then Alice is local, and B delivered to Bob. So what I would like to transfer, it is not A and B, it is C. So I have third photon, C, and quantum state of photon C is like this. You know, remember what we said about qubit. So I would like to transfer this to B. Okay, so it is Alice. Alice applies a unitary operation. So basically, we have entangled qubits. So based on measurements, we will have some action over here. And results. So there are four possible states in Bell space for this stuff. So when Alice measures this, she puts information using two bits. So information can be 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, and 0, 1. So each one corresponding to one possible outcome of the measurement. After that, basically, this is destroyed. No more entangled states. Bob, this guy, now contains information about this. But it is somehow random. So what we need Alice to communicate. Alice will be sending either this or this or that. The next slide will explain, you know, a kind of exact mathematical treatment. So then, with this information, Bob measures state, and eventually, you know, make transformation based on information he gets. Makes unitary transformation, so with Pauli principles, we will see. In this case, then, we have information that recreation of this stuff is done this by measurement Bob achieved. It goes like this. So four possible states, you know. Could be one of four Bell states. You know, you have two particles. You have this is a well-known state, four outcomes. So when Alice measures, could be like this, right? Then we apply. This is a kind of unitary transformation when you have entangled stuff. So this entanglement quantum state collapses. So let's say we have this, and you know, when it comes, we can basically, based on this, represent different combinations like this. So it is a mathematical treatment of what I already said. At the receiving side, we have four outcomes, four possible outcomes. If Bob measures what is already there, nothing can be done, you know. So Bob found this is stuff, and you know, or, you know, a kind of trivial unitary operation, so it means nothing. If measures like this, maybe this corresponding to this, this is unitary gate is supposed to be done by this Pauli matrix. And in this case, you know, it will be like this. In this case, remaining case, it will be like this. So you see, basically, the point is, after this measurement, the quantum state of C B is exactly as quantum state of C. So information is transferred. But we needed classical channel. That was the reason when I said fine print and regular print. Now, one more stuff. If you would like to have some kind of regeneration of repeaters, this stuff is also possible. Let's imagine this stuff. We have Alice. Just one state. We have Bob, V2, B1 and B2, and of course we have third party, Carol, having one. So at the very beginning, these two are entangled, and these two are entangled. So what happens after that? Bob performs again projective measurements on these two and communicates results to Carol, the same what I did. So Carol does the same what I just explained Bob does in case with communicating with Alice. So now what we have is that A and C are entangled without interaction between Alice and Carol. Why this is important? This is principle of quantum repeaters. So what I talk that maximum distance is whatever, 150 kilometer. With this stuff, it is possible to extend, you know, the same as optical amplifiers or optical repeaters to extend the total distance of a quantum communication. Okay, so that was a kind of very quick basics, and hopefully, you know, we can move. The point is, we are really talking about quantum states. So in order to achieve that, we are talking about single photons. If I have more than one photon, which can happen, then there is possibility, you know, that it could be misused. If it happens, if I have two photons, and there is Eve's action, Eve takes one. And so basically on this stuff he gains information and the second one is retransmitted. So it is very dangerous stuff. It is split photon attack and very kind of inconvenient, very difficult to counterattack, but there is some method how to do with that. So it is in case if I don't have single photon. Now, single photon generation is extremely difficult. We'll talk about that. And I talked to Galina, and Galina was kind of joking, but hopefully, eventually, we will try to do something about that. Okay, so what is quantum state? We talk about that representation, cats, you know. We can say, okay, let's try to use what is the most convenient. We can produce quantum states in different levels, in atom, electrons, and we are really talking about photons. So polarization, you know, phase, geometrical modes like orbital angular momentum, we'll talk about that. And of course, if there is some other idea, that is even better. So I will later on go through several examples when people come with some very nice ideas how to incorporate everything, not to be so clumsy, to be kind of very promising stuff. Okay, so now let's move to technicals. How we really communicate? Let's talk about polarization. Polarization as quantum state was used so far mostly for experiments we are talking about. So again, these guys, they started this famous protocol, 84, using this stuff. So what is about? Qubit is encoded in polarization state. So at the very beginning, we are supposed to pick up two non-orthogonal bases. So it could be like this, which is diagonal. It could be like this, which is rectilinear. And then in each state, we can imprint information related to 0 and 1. So you see, they are not orthogonal. So you will see, we are statistically picking up one base. So let's say, in this case, if it is this base, binary 1 is 90 degrees, binary 0 is 0 degrees. In this case, it is like this. So this is the key, how to proceed. And of course, it comes to be ability to create four polarization states that will be eventually measured by some kind of statistical attempt. Okay, so then they communicate over channel, and we will go through exercise one by one. And so sender will randomly pick up the base. We will have pseudo-random sequence, and you know, Alice will just randomly, you know, without either this or this, and encode information. So there will be stream 01, 01, 01, pseudo random, and she will pick up randomly where to put information. Okay, so for this step, polarization is in receiving side. Polarization is also measured randomly. So of course, when you have random, there is always possibility like a half cases you may be right. And then after that, there is some communication between sender, and which is Alice and Bob, through classical channel. And we will talk about that, what it is. This protocol, this guy, Bennett, proposed, you know, maybe we can simplify it instead of two bases, but I just go like this. I have two states. You know, I pick up, this is binary one, and when you consider, it is really the same, but just a little bit, you know, simplified stuff. Of course, some analysis said, if you just go like this, security may be a little bit lower than this. So there is always discussion, you know, is it really quantum state what we are presenting or not? Okay, let's go like this. So we have pseudo-random sequence like this. And you know, then Alice picks up the base and sends information like this. Obviously, she picks up this stuff, sending this. Then Bo picks up again randomly base. So let's say Bo pick this one, and this is the result. So Bo achieved here. So we have, in this case, you know, this and this, that's okay. This and this, and you know, so randomly, Bob managed to basically measure like almost half. So basically, I put a little bit more. It is what we have here. Whenever Bob picks up the same basis, he gets exact result statistically. So in this case, we are talking now about some key, which is called secret key. Right. After they did this, so Alice sends, Bob receives, measures, they need somehow to communicate to see, okay, what is the next? So how they communicate? Bob announced the type, so basis to Alice. So they discovered to each other what happened. And after that, going through some process, they will find, we will follow that process to some secret key. The point is, from the very beginning, this is raw bit rate. I would like to have this very fast, 10 gigabits, for example. There is possibility, no, there is a kind of certainty that Bob will pick up 5 of them, 5 gigabits, but not all of them are secure. I will proceed with several steps until I get the key. So what we are talking about here, we are talking about some raw bit rate, we are talking about secret or very often used sifted key, and starting from here, we are now moving to extract absolutely secret key. So in practice, it is like this. I have photon source, and I have this information, and you know the process what I explained, Alice is speaking like this. It is coming through this channel, and is attack, and you know we have polarization beam splitter, so picking up this base and this base, this detector will click. So that is the point how I get sifted key. Again, this is absolutely a kind of the best resemblance of quantum communication, quantum key distribution. The point is, in addition to Eve attack, this is not a clean channel. This is noisy channel. So how I can distinguish between regular noise and Eve's attack? No, I'm not going to do that. Basically, everything, I assume it is due to Eve's attack. An assumption is that, you know, it is a kind of superhuman, everything, so whatever is possible, Eve can do. the second option is, instead of polarization, I can use phase. So this was proposed. Of course, I'm just using some very illustrative examples how to do that. Again, you see two states and two options. This guy was very clever, proposing, you know, a kind of Mach Zehnder, and, you know, you're using bases. One is to pick up the base, and the second one is to pick up the value. And you have similar stuff. When you go, what was sent, what was received, so the point is similar, just using a phase instead of polarization. We talk about BB84 protocol. Very, very quickly about E91. So BB84 protocol is based on uncertainty principle. This protocol is based on non-cloning theorem. So both of them, they have some kind of physical background. So when you have this two photons, or two entangled qubits on different locations, you know, whenever you do some measurement on one side, there will be implication on the other side. You can expect opposite result on the other because of that entanglement. So it means that whatever information they align, it will be inverted. So you just reinvert, and that is the same. When you consider this, either BB84 and E91, they are in similar in age. Okay, so we saw what is all about. Now, how we can do that? We have quantum source. It is ideally single photon. We need to imprint this pseudo-random sequence. And we need to have classical communication channel. So in addition to quantum channel, which could be fiber or free space, to transmit qubits, quantum states, we need to have this channel to transmit classical bits. And here you see a kind of two options that just symbolize what's going on at the receiving side. This is how it works. I need to have this raw bit rate, and it is created, it is communicated qubits, so this is receiving side. I may not receive everything, there is some loss. So at the very beginning, my bit rate was, let's say, 10 gigabit. 10 gigabit, so I have 10 gigabit clock, and each clock means one photon, and, you know, every seventh photon is lost because of some reason, so basically there is loss. So from here, we talk about shifted key, 0.5, so 50% probability that both pick up wrong basis. So eventually, from the very beginning, I came to shifted key. Then, there is some communication between Bob and Alice. First, I will try really to see what was the reason for this. Is there anything coming from noisy channel? Before I accuse that Eve that, you know, she causes everything. So in this case, we are really talking about some information reconciliation which is heavily related to advanced error correction. So for error correction, you know, starting from classical parity checking to advanced methods like low density parity coding, turbo coding, you know, polar coding and everything. So it is pretty much the same as in classical communications, but with some specific skill. So with this stuff, I help somehow to eliminate something that I know is coming from noisy channel. And at the same time, I have very good idea what is the impact of Eve. So now the question is, okay, you know, I discovered that this rate, error rate, maybe 20% is coming because of noisy channel and 80% is coming because of eave. And by the way, the total quantum bit error rate is less than 2%. So now there is that 2% good or not? There is probability analysis. And some people, and there is discussion. When you look through papers, they say, you know, there is always some limit. If it is below some limit, which is currently maybe 5%, it is good. Then, you know, I said, look, from this key, eventually 10 gigabit became 2 gigabit. I would like to make life of Eve more difficult. So even I have some secure key, I would like to shorten that using some kind of hash function. You know, hash function, when you have input, you multiply and it is squeezed. So eventually, I came here. And, you know, using that, there is probability that Eve gain information, if I put this, is a kind of going to zero. So that's the point. And you see, all communication in yellow is done through quantum channel, single photons, and all that stuff is through public channel, which means that I need, if I have optical transmission, I need my public channel, maybe another wavelength. If I have quantum free space, maybe my classical channel could be RF link between receiver and transmitter. So it is a negotiation. So let's talk about just a little bit what is third and fourth step. So, as I mentioned, information reconciliation is really to make sure that I get rid of errors through noisy channel. It is the same advanced forward error correction coding. You pick up, you correct. So somehow, if there are errors, and at the same time you discover later on, when you eliminate this and you establish some code, you will test it. So I get from 10 gigabit, I get, let's say, 3 gigabit. I will sacrifice 0.5 gigabit because we know and communicate to see how many bits are okay, because every discrepancy is now because of Eve's attack. I eliminated noise applying this stuff. Privacy applications, so I already mentioned it. So picking up is just, you know, from a set of publicly known functions. Okay, so finally, as I said, this is the key. Lot of stuff is to find, and it is very complex, to find expressions for this Q there based on different parameters. You have this and this, and you know, and in one of my papers, you will see how I calculated that for multiple cases. Okay, so I need single photon. This is ideal case. And because single photon should be detected individually, just opposite case. This is case, I will return. In classical communication, if I have regular pulses, first I need to have clock as high as possible. I have a number of photons. And what I have, if I have detector, you know, there is some integration effect. In this case, no, really, I don't want any integration. I would like to have action of any single photon here. And you know, it is not so easy because based on Poisson distribution, maybe not single photon, maybe not photon at all. But let's say I would like to have single photons. And then, you know, maybe using polarization state as quantum state, let's say. I would like high frequency pulses. This is the key, high frequency. If I increase frequency, my bit rate, eventually secure key, will be faster, high rate. But how about photodetector? It is nightmare in terms of photodetector, how to distinguish, because there is state, there is jitter, there is integration effect. And you will see we are using now avalanche photodiodes in breakdown mode, like, you know, a kind of counters. Then, this is I already mentioned, I need really to have this powerful stuff. As I mentioned, LDPC coding is the same method applied for classical communication, but for specifics, there is so many class of LDCP, LDPC. We need to generate this, to synthesize. And repeaters, a lot of guys try to design repeaters, you know, based on that third-party Kerov, if you remember. But somehow, the results here are not following results over there. So, what can be done? Single photon source. I can use this stuff. This can go to Max Zender, if you remember one example. And eventually, after I have pulses and modulation, I can attenuate and hopefully, you know, having very precise code that, you know, I have single. But again, there is statistics of this Poisson distribution. Even if I do that, there is probability, you know, that there will be two, there will be nothing, and there will be one of them. So, what can be done here? Small optical power is really small. You know, in addition to attenuation, what can be done? So, in next page, I believe I have some. They try with this stuff. So everything should be small. If you would like to have a single photon, it means that size should be nano size, optical cavity. We are not talking about lasers. There is no resonant cavity. It is just cavity that will direct output photons over there. So some techniques, you know, from papers, we can use this single atom, single dye molecules, you know, this stuff, and you know, this stuff. So single quantum dot. As I mentioned, I talk to Galina. You know, Galina is always joking, but I believe there is possibility that we can do something about this. So single quantum dot, you know, it is, how can you manipulate with this? So single quantum dot, you can have electrical or optical pumping. So let me see, something like this. Look, it is everything should be a kind of nano cavity and optical pumping, and so this is example from this guy like 10 years ago. The point is that temperature should be really low. We need to eliminate noise. So in this case, ideally something like this, and as I mentioned, Santori claimed that he has nearly a single photon source. So again, there is some room for improvement. So somebody can ask, okay, what is the difference between single and, you know, attenuated, if we can do that, you know, both ways? There was some analysis also done, 10 years ago. It was interesting. You see, rate, it is very small. You know, in this case, it is a kind of 100 kilo or eventually. You see, there is up to 15 dB. We may use that attenuated, but 15 dB is not so big distance. So you see points, and they analyze. Eventually, when we would like to achieve really a high margin, there is single photon source. So I just pick up this as illustration. So there will be always discussion, okay, you know, if I don't have single photon source, so who cares, I will just use that. Yeah, but again, probably a difference will be 10 times or 10 to some power eventually. Okay, so single source, how we can get entangled photons? I pick up also some ideas presented earlier. This was very early result. 20 years ago or so, people start talking about quantum communication, but a lot of hype about everything. So eventually it became mature, and you will see, I would say, some very impressive results. So basically like this. You know, if I have half beam splitter, This is something like this. So input this one or this kind of, this is zero input, but it is produces this quantum state, half beam. Or if I have pump, you know, there is a possibility going through down conversion that I have this stuff. And the question is, so this is nonlinear crystal type 2, rotating this halfway plate, I can produce four Bell states. This is possible, but the question is, what is really efficiency? What is the chance that photon will you know, react and eventually I will have a kind of entangled state? Not so high. That's the point. You know, when I have this, this looks nice, you know, that, but you know, what would be efficiency if I have a stream of pump, two pump photons, you know, maybe every like tenth of them will produce something, not enough. So when we talk about, just to elaborate, you know, this is when you have this stuff, I believe all these guys, they somehow try to do this. So this is well-known stuff, you know, you should have energy conservation and phase matching, you know, when you have pump and when you have idler and when you have nonlinearity. Eventually, it means you produce some streams, you go to Alice, maybe local, and you send other to Bob, and after that, you know, proceed with protocols we were talking about. Again, it is the same stuff, you know, just they use as nonlinear stuff like structural fibers in normal dispersion region. So you see, when you have pump, because of those nonlinearity, we have two photons generated. So it is down conversion in this case. Single photon detectors. You know, they should be very fast. So distinguish before another photon comes, I don't want to have any residual effect, any integration effect. So some options so far. Nonlinear regime for avalanche photodiode. You put high bias, high gain, and but dark current is going up as well. And by the way, dark current is big enemy. It is noise. And we have dark current rate, counting how many clicks are because of that current within, you know, a second. Then, you know, as usual, suspects, you know, other photomultipliers. For example, it is better in terms of signal-to-noise ratio, but it is high voltage, it is more expensive, and it is. So what was so far? As far as I know, maybe there is somebody, NTT managed to use APD with clock rate of 10 gigabits. And of course, I believe that APD was coming from NEC. It is specially designed APD structure. So now the question is, okay, I don't have single photon source and there is possibility. What can I do about that? Then people come, okay, I'm going to use modified protocol decoy. So if there is possibility that, let's say, it could be one photon, maybe two photons, or zero photons, something like that, I will make life of Eve miserable. I will deliberately send some decoy pulses. And after that, she will be confused without knowing what's going on. Maybe she say, okay, yeah, two photons, I will pick up this one. And she picks up decoy, so who cares about that? And that is the most promising methodology right now. And of course, you have so complex analysis about probability, blah, blah, but that's what is it. Mainly, several systems right now in operation, they use this protocol. I will explain. I believe I have some example over there. So the point is, the most dangerous stuff, you know, that split photon number splitting attack, what I explained, I believe I deleted, now it is a kind of neutralized. Eve is confused. And daily statistics, I can recognize, and Bob can recognize, based on the statistics, because regular quantum information photons will have different statistics from decoy photons or decoy pulses. I would like to increase bit rate. You see how difficult reduction eventually from 10 gigabit I'm coming down to less than 100 kilobit. Not so good. The most promising, or I don't know how to say, I'm supposed as always to do some kind of parallel transmission. So this is scheme of transmission. If you just pick up, it looks that I don't have battery anymore, but if you pick up this front, it is what we talk about. But if I have option to add some parallelism, I can do more. Can I use WDM? Yes, you can. NEC recently, like 2 years ago, achieved more than 1 meg. You see, 1 meg, we are talking about more than 100 gig, and 1 meg is heroic achievement, using 8 lambdas. What else can I use? So it is like spectral multiplexing. Can I use spatial multiplexing, spatial modes? I believe yes, and that's what I did in some paper. What is spatial mode? So we have multi-mode fibers, we have multi-core fibers. Can we use LG modes? I believe yes. Can we use LG mode for free space? There are some number of experiments. So possibility, if I just multiply, then somebody can ask, okay, why multiply? If I have options, maybe I can use a kind of multi-level modulation or multi-something. Yeah, but in such a case, it's case with log. In this case, it is case linearly. So increasing bit rate is, this stuff is better than log. So eventually, you know, there is big discrepancy. So if I have 8 states, 2 to 8, it is 2 to 3rd power. So I will increase bit rate by 3. If I use parallel, I will increase by 8. So, you know, the same principle. So that was the reason we are talking about something like this. And so we mentioned about that. Of course, I just pick up kind of generic stuff to analyze. The key is here, you know, you have a Q-bear function, you have this entropy stuff, and you have some analysis. So this is what we did. And by the way, this guy is from NEC, who did some experiments over there. So this was our work, showing some kind of promising stuff when you have transmission of multiple parallel channels. So you see how it works. What was achieved experimentally in a heroic experiment, you know, it is pretty much, but we can go with bit rates above 10 and 100 meg. It is big stuff. So assuming some kind of this stuff, you know, what can be applied, we didn't have experiments, so eventually, you know, supporting the experiments. Talking about spatial modes, just I guess we are out of time very quickly. So this is, you know, LG modes, OEM modes. Then you have multi-mode fiber, so it is a kind of vertex. You can use this. This is stuff, and you know, the point is they interact. There is some coupling, and you are somehow supposed to interact. The same is with turbulent atmosphere. You know, when you have this stuff, applying conglomerate method of analysis, you are somehow supposed to do very precise. And of course, forward error correction is something that helps. So again, this is work we did with respect to fibers. Achieve results. I guess you may be curious to see what was really achieved. The highest bit rate at 1 megabit or 50 kilometer of optical fiber was achieved recently by NEC and Hokkaido University. The longest distance, 260, was achieved by University of Science in China using this protocol. So 260, and I have some illustration of results. Distance record, free space, Canary Island, some European projects, like consortium, University of Vienna, Zurich, some guys from France. They consider this to be very important. Why? When you consider, you know, distance between space station, Earth station is something like 400 kilometers, but when you have atmosphere, what really matters is when density is high. So after that, you know, it could be 400, could be 4 million, so who cares? Because in this case, I don't have effects that will have impact. And some people say, okay, maybe if I have satellites like this, I can eventually do zigzag distribution of secure key. You know, it is futuristic, but, you know, there is some very good base to believe that. What was done? So this is courtesy of a friend of mine who is professor at the University of Vienna. You know, I mentioned some results, but you see, the point, all experiments are done through dark fiber. So I would like to achieve something. This is almost like lab experiment. I would like to achieve something. Give me this fiber. Give me that. So ideal situation. And you see, bit rate, a kind of, this is 1 meg. And this is distance. So you see how it fits. But the second, if I already have infrastructure in place, and I would like really to use what is deployed, it means if I have WDM system, I would like to achieve some quantum transmission. What can be done? How they will interact? Because my WDM system is 100 times signal is stronger. There will be coupling and so on. There are some experiments done over there. And of course, he summarized that. It was very nice from him that he gave it to me. So you see, distance is much shorter. You can go, so 50 kilometers, look about bit rate. It is almost miserable, right? So you see difficulties. Whether to proceed what I have in place or give me new infrastructure, maybe we expect that sometimes in the future current fibers will be exhausted in terms of capacity, so we can expect new deployment. It will be new generation, not necessarily single mode fibers. It could be multi-core, multi-mode, few mode, not just, you know. And then when we plan this, something can be done. This is, I believe, still in place between two banks in Japan. So what is distance? 45 kilometers of installed fibers. So it was a consortium of Japanese companies, NTT, Mitsubishi, NEC, or so somebody providing this, that, and whatever, but it is working. So they have statistics, and I believe they are measuring that as we speak. So then, you know, it is, without experiments like this, you cannot really have proof that principle, you know, unbreakable code is working. So far, it is working. And this is what they use. So in this case, it is a kind of base modulation, a phase modulation. The second experiment was done over there. The longest one, again, the same principle. You have pulses. You apply phase modulation. You have two photodiodes that click depending on selected states. Now, this was taken from this heroic experiment. And this is very illustrative. You see how it works with respect to fiber length and how bit rate is going up. I talk about Q bare, and I said probably 2% is good enough. So some people, this is ideal, you know. So discussion is, can I allow like this? Can I allow like this? It is what I said, probably, if I have operation 10,000 hours or 100,000 hours, maybe I can make some experimental verification. But look at this. So these guys probably, they had very nice place, but didn't have time to enjoy. So it is a transmission, 144 kilometers between two islands. So they use entangled photons. So one of them was at Ali side, and the second one was transmitted. So, you know, for skeptical people say, look, sending photons to atmosphere, and probably there are like a lot of salty particles. And what they achieve? Yeah, they did it. So this was one of the biggest proofs so far what is possible, and, you know, some kind of encouraging stuff. We need, you know, for younger people, younger researchers, to see that, you know, that effort is kind of, we will lead to some success. Okay, so let's summarize. We are talking about qubits, foundation for communication and for computing, which is a kind of, you know, fluid state. We need some key devices, of course. Without having that, you know, we can still apply something, and it was achieved, and it's a lot of experiments. What is left? There is still a lot of room. How to use a decoy manipulation? How to apply powerful information reconciliation? And how to produce entangled photons? So the idea always coming. And then, but having in mind what was achieved so far, I put into perspective that this is possible. We can go with bit rates above 100 meg, which is huge. In such a case, we can talk about something. So the point is, as always, we couldn't make step without having WD and without having amplifiers. So like 20 years ago, a lot of you know that it was, yeah, what is the next step? Then the amplifiers, then, and all of a sudden we are talking about terabits, 10 terabits, and so on. In this case, similar stuff. But the point is, who is going to do that? I don't think that Google is going to you know, to support this. Google is known that, you know, give me latest, greatest, I don't give you money. Somehow, somebody is supposed to make some heroic experiments, some proof, or, you know, so far, the biggest effort was done in Japan and European Union, and it was done by some kind of consortium. So anyway, myself, I'm optimistic about that. So we'll see what happens, but at least, you know, this topic, you will never have people just say, okay, you know, it is achievable, so enthusiastic, yeah, 90%, or skeptical people. It will be almost like qubit. You have skeptical, you have enthusiastic, and you know probability of this, that, so they form like a qubit state of real people. Okay, so I guess, so, I'm done.